Good evening and welcome to Hope Lutheran Church. I am Pastor Mark. I'm blessed to serve as the pastor here, and I've been here for 9 years. And one of the joys of my ministry is the Christmas concert, because I get to be in the pew. I get to be listening, and I get to be appreciating the gifts that God gives to us through voice and an instrument, just like you, and that's why you're here. So whether you're here for the first time tonight or you've been here before, I want you to be able to sit back and to appreciate the message that is given tonight. We ask the Lord to bless our evening and to bless this concert, and so we begin with a prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the goodness of this day. And as we gather from all different places with all different things happening in our lives and in our hearts, we ask that you would have this concert be a blessing for us. Through the songs, through the message, through the music, may it speak to our hearts, may it calm us, and may it lift our eyes heavenward to what you have done for us. Lord, help us to see that the King shall come and who that King is. Lord, bless this concert for Jesus' sake. Amen. Enjoy.
God with us, Emmanuel. Good evening, everyone. How do we begin to tell the story? The composer Marty Parks wrote this wonderful cantata, A Child, a King. And tonight we will sing the story for you again. This is our story. You all know this story because you're here. So let's just think about what this whole story and the Christ's birth and Christmas has given us. So much to be grateful for. So much to celebrate, celebrate, celebrate. So we shall celebrate again this evening and remind ourselves why we are here. My name is Pauline Soman. I am the music director for Hope Lutheran Church. Please enjoy the evening's program.
And so, all present watched in amazement as Jesus quietly was born in the village of Bethlehem.
Still we see. Jesus' birth was not intended for the religiously satisfied or the spiritually indifferent. It is a message of hope for the poor, the humble, all whose hearts are wounded and whose spirits are broken.
is a story of a people waiting for a Messiah. Now God sent his son to be our savior. This is our story.
Oh, weary world and empty sky. to make his entrance among us in the most unlikely way. And so many came to behold the mystery. And like them, we joined their proclamation, Noel, Noel, born is the King.
Joy. Hallelujah! He shall reign forever. King of kings, Lord of lords. Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
The Hallelujah Chorus. I was a boy, probably 8 or 9 years old, the first time I heard it, lived out in the country in Minnesota, and was at into a bigger city and in an auditorium with a mass choir. And I never had heard a song like that. So it has always stayed with me. And so when I hear the Hallelujah Chorus, there are different memories that come to mind. I think of a member of ours who passed away 2 years ago yesterday, Bill Farley. Bill Farley used to sit right about there, young man, right about there. And the Hallelujah Chorus would start, and Bill Farley would stand up. He would stand up, and I think the people around would kind of go, what? And he stayed standing the entire song. Bill Farley was not a small man, so I think the people behind were kind of, please. Now, do you know why Bill Farley stood up for the Hallelujah Chorus? It's a tradition. It goes back 270 plus years, because the Hallelujah Chorus was written 281 years ago. And so what happened is a few years after it was written, it was performed in the presence of King George II in England. And as that music started for the Hallelujah Chorus, King George stood up. Now, if the king stands up, what does everybody have to do? Everybody stands up. And it was thought King George stood up because he recognized, even though he is king, he pays homage to the King of Kings. And ever since then, that is a tradition for some people to stand up during the Hallelujah Chorus, but not everybody knows that. I think of Bill Farley, but I also think of George Handel. George Handel was the man who wrote the Hallelujah Chorus. His story is a riches to rags to riches story. He was born in Europe, and he was famous as a younger man because he wrote operas. And operas, well, that was the going music back in the day, and he wrote over 40 operas. He became famous, he became rich off of that. But then operas, they kind of went out for a little bit, and he wasn't a financially smart. He let his finances run through his fingers, and so he became a poor man. And then when he was 52 years old, he had a debilitating stroke. And he traveled to England, and he tried to put life together again with all of those weaknesses, and he started writing oratorios. Oratorios, it's a type of music where you teach by music, and that's how he tried to scrape together a living, but he had depression and weakness. And then a man, Charles Jennings, I think, he wanted to write a certain piece of work. And he had the lyrics, he had the text, but he needed somebody to write the music. And so he knew that George Handel was around, and so he asked George Handel, he said, if I give you these texts, can you put it to music? And George Handel, over the next 24 days, wrote 259 pages of musical manuscript. It was an incredible outpouring of work. And when he got done, he turned it in, and that whole composition is now known as Handel's Messiah. It is called the most beautiful sermon ever sung, because the text that was given to him was 53 select passages from the Bible, 53 different sections of Scripture from the Bible. And that's what George Handel now set to music, to tell the story. Now, it was told that for one of his oratorios, when he did the oratorio and it was performed, somebody after the concert came up to him and said, that was wonderful. That music was so entertaining. And he got upset because he said, my music is not meant to be entertaining. My music is meant to teach. And especially when it came to Handel's Messiah, he would probably be upset that we call it Handel's Messiah because it is the story of the Messiah. He wanted the story of the Christ told. And part of the story of the Christ is Christmas. And I think we understand in today's world, Christmas is something that sometimes is just on the surface. People know about Christmas and a Christmas story. And you can hit on Netflix and you can see umpteen movies on the Christmas stories, right? But the Christmas story is more than that. And it's even beyond a baby in a manger. It is a story from the beginning and the end. It is a story of salvation. It is a story of what we, who we are, and that we are far from God and separated from God, but that God saw that, and so God came to us, Emmanuel. And that Jesus grew, and he lived a perfect life. And Handel takes us to where Jesus went. Handel takes us to the cross. And he takes us from the cross to the tomb, and from the tomb to heaven, and from heaven to Judgment Day, where the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords appears. And in teaching, he shows us what that means. That he went to the cross to take every single one of our sins. And he attaches a promise to that, to the whole world, and he says to every single person that whoever believes and is baptized shall be saved. It is my promise, the King of Kings says to you. And so when he appears again, you and I don't have to run scared and afraid, because the one who is King of Kings and Lord of Lords is my shepherd and my friend and my lamb. When George Handel got done writing 259 pages of musical manuscript in 24 days, he wrote on the very bottom, SDG. And he handed it in. Young people, do that on your tests. SDG. What does SDG stand for? In the Latin, Sola Dei Gloria, which means to God be the glory. This is what I offer. So I have a question for you. And my question is not, next year if you're here and we have the Hallelujah Chorus, are you going to be the brave one to stand up? Yeah. We'll see. Big talk now. We'll see next year. But that's not my question. My question is, how do we live each day? And my encouragement to you every single day is to wake up every single day and say, SDG. To God be the glory. Amen? Amen? Amen. The next song is also from Handel's Messiah, and it talks about the beauty of being able to share that message of Jesus.
Thank you. We're going to sing one more song. Please continue standing if you feel that you can. Just get a few of those wiggles out so then we can join our beautiful orchestra.
Thank you. it's almost Christmas time. There I stood in another line, trying to buy the last gift or two. Not really in the Christmas mood. Standing right in front of me was a little boy waiting anxiously, pacing around like little boys do. In his hand he held a pair of shoes, and his clothes were worn and old. He was dirty from head to toe. And when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy said there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know the shoes will make her smile. Want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. They counted pennies for what seemed like year, and the cashier said, "Son, it's not enough here." He searched his pocket frantically. Then he turned and he looked at me. He said, "Mama made Christmas good at a house. Most years she just did without." Tell me, sir, what am I gonna do? Somehow I've gotta buy her these Christmas shoes. So I laid the money down. I just had to help him out. Forget the look on his face when he said, "Mama's gonna look so great." Sir, I wanna buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size.
If my mom meets Jesus. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kissed your little baby, you kissed the face of God. Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know?
Oh,
Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know?
The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak,
the praises of the Lamb.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations?
Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am.
Mary, did you know?
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 Mary, did you know? Love incarnate, love divine. Star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the Savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. Noel, Noel, come and see what God has done. Noel,
God.
Oh,
Thank you.